This 2016 Corvette Z06 was my most complete job of the year. I installed everything from a full K40 system along with a full integrated audio system with a ton of new and modified fabrication. We installed the K40 RL360i Expert system, which contained a front and rear radar receiver along with two laser diffusers in the front and one laser diffuser in the rear. I fabricated brackets to house my front laser diffusers and rear radar receiver. That way, they could bolt to the vehicle and still have the bumpers be serviceable. When we removed the rear bumper, we installed sound dampening along the fiberglass panel to cut down on road noise. After that was done, I fabricated a bracket to house the rear radar receiver and riveted the mount to the rear fiberglass panels like the rest of the accessories on the bumper. The Expert system from K40 comes with the main controller. I decided the perfect spot for this would be where the factory cigarette lighter resided in the center console. It was molded in place of the cigarette lighter and now had the ability to be displayed when needed and pushed flush with the dash when not in use. The audio system was going to be quite a task because there was going to be a lot of fabrication to make the audio system come together. I chose to use the new Focal Kevlar three ways for the front. The front comes with three ways, but they chose to have the tweeters in the upper dash firing off the windshield. Being the reflection cannot be controlled, I decided I was going to make my own pods for the tweeters. There was a great long area on the top of the door panel that would be the perfect spot. I came up with a design that complemented the lines of the doors and started stacking some acrylic to make the shape of the pod. I used acrylic because I wanted this pod to look in 10 years like the day that it left. Acrylic is a great material because it is resistant to moisture and the elements and can withstand a broad temperature range. I stacked the acrylic until I was able to house the tweeter. Once that was done, I fabricated an acrylic trim ring that I would finish off in a brushed aluminum 3M wrap. I made a mini press grille that would enclose the tweeter into the housing. I also created an additional insert on the back of the pod that would be finished off in a black matching leather. Once that pod was created and the trim was molded in, I shot the pods with poly primer and sealer to join all of my materials together. I embedded magnets into my pod to magnetize the trim to the pod. That way you could service a tweeter. The rear leather insert also used magnets to attach to the pod. The main structure of the pod was painted in matte black paint to match some of the plastic on the door panels. The grille was painted red to match the grille of the mid on the door. In total, I was able to include four different elements from the OE door panel. By doing this, my pod does not stand out as aftermarket. I embedded two 1/4-20 easy lock inserts into the bottom of my pod, that way I had an engineered way to securely bolt it to the door panel. When the door panel was off, the mounting holes were cut and the stainless hardware attached the pod to the door. Quick disconnects were then added to the tweeter lines, that way you could service the door panels. With the tweeter pods now being complete, I moved on to the mid and woofer of each door. I made speaker adapters for my woofer out of HDPE to bolt into the factory locations. The speakers were recessed into the adapters and finished off with fast rings. The inner and outer door skins were finished off with sound skins dampening material. I constructed the adapters for my mid using 1/4-inch ABS plastic. The audio system would run through a Mosconi 68 DSP, which was mounted on the inner rear fiberglass panel where the OEM subwoofer was located. I used nutserts into the fiberglass panel, that way I could bolt the DSP to the fiberglass. To the right of the DSP sat a 10 farad stinger capacitor that was also bolted securely to the fiberglass. The controller for the DSP was installed behind the motorized screen. I constructed a housing finished off with matching black suede flock, that way it would blend right in. The Mosconi 68 would send its corrected signal to the three Mosconi AS amplifiers. We ran the entire system active, which meant there were no passive crossovers. Every speaker would run off its own channel of amplification. When creating the amp rack and rear subwoofer enclosure, there was a few things that would be necessary to keep full functionality. We had to retain enough space for the removable top to dock in. We also needed access to the battery, storage compartment, and also the BCM and all factory fuses that sit right in the center of the floor. I came up with my initial design for the amp rack and then started incorporating my materials to create the finished look. I made a removable insert to allow access to the BCM, fuses, system fuses, and the DSP. I embossed the Corvette logo into the leather and made the insert removable using 12 magnets flushed under the suede. I accented the trim panel with acrylic. I accented the sides to light up the area for the battery and the storage pocket. I also accented each Mosconi amplifier to highlight the product. The shape of the tweeter pods made its way to the amplifier openings to carry the shape throughout the car. The amp rack was molded up to the transition point, which would flow into the subwoofer enclosure. The transition belt was made from 1/4 inch brushed aluminum, 1/2 inch leather, and then one more layer of 1/4 inch brushed aluminum. The subwoofer enclosure was made using the layering method. It was the easiest way to create the organic shape that I was looking for. With over 40 layers, it came to be quite complex to create. When I achieved the finished shape, the enclosure was then sprayed with a layer of poly primer to completely seal the layers. The enclosure was then trimmed out on the front and back to offer inserts and layers for the different materials I would be using. I used 2 8-inch focal flax subwoofers and created 2 trim rings with press grills to protect them. The trim rings and openings for my grille carried the constant shape for my pods and amp rack. I finished off the removable front insert with a white LED that illuminated under the opening. I did this to show the depth that was created with the insert. The top of the enclosure was wrapped with a matching red spice leather. A lot of the design for the enclosure I pulled from the seats. The back of the seats were gloss black that were recessed into the red leather, so naturally the transition point from the back of the seats to my enclosure would match. I used 2 layers of black acrylic that would finish off the back of the enclosure. The top was still able to be removed and docked in over top all the equipment. There were inches to spare in front of the subwoofers to the front edge of the top. The finished design of the audio system that was installed pulled multiple design elements from the car itself. It is what makes a difference from aftermarket equipment being added to the vehicle versus having it be a part of the vehicle itself.